Hello YouTube, this video is going to show how to assemble all this gear into a prosumer level portable two-channel podcasting recording rig. Now while the owner's manuals for each individual piece of equipment will get you familiar with that piece of equipment, a comprehensive reference guide like the Yamaha Sound Reinforcement Handbook will describe how all the parts work together. I'd recommend getting really familiar with section 3 here on the decibel sound level and related items, as it talks about loudness, perceived loudness, and how the ear actually works. So setting up a component level system starts with patching everything together. I'm using FireWire interface into a MacBook Pro, so gotta use Thunderbolt connectors. This one has DSP. Which I'll show later on in the video why I choose this particular model. This is the back of the Focusrite. This model has two headphone monitoring outputs. That's why I like it. Always carry a backup. Two devices when one fries is equal to one device. Anytime electronics are concerned, you'll always want to have a backup. With this setup, I prefer to use FireWire for live recording because of the way it prioritizes isochronous signals. USB tends to drop out from time to time, and when it does, it's not pretty. I've never had FireWire drop out once the two devices are locked together. The audio travels from the Focusrite to the MacBook Pro and is recorded there, but it's also prudent to have a secondary recording device to record a backup of everything. And for that, I use the Zoom H5. The Zoom H5 connects directly into the Sapphire. The monitoring output records regardless of what the MacBook Pro is doing. Connecting up the monitoring headphones into both the outputs. Here I show assembling the K&M 25600 boom stands that I use. Not too many people get to see the 25600 because it's a relatively expensive stand. This is one of those areas where you buy once and you cry once. You don't want the hardware to get in the way of the performance. A lot of people have quote-unquote technical difficulties during recording, and that's usually from poor choice in execution and hardware. Sennheiser E835 microphones, that's what I'm talking into right now. Not the most expensive microphone, but with the right EQ and the right know-how, they sound very, very good. Because the E835s are dynamic microphones and require quite a bit of gain, I use microphone preamps, cloud lifters, to improve the signal-to-noise ratio. The way that these passive preamps work is they use phantom power to drive an internal amplifier, so you'll want to mount them as close to the microphone as possible to reduce noise. That's why they're there. The only thing in this setup that I don't have shown that I do now use is an acoustic curtain behind me when I record. I also have shock mounts for the microphones. I use metal pop filters because they're durable and they're easy to clean. Once everything's connected, I test for a signal. Then I open up the mixing control software. Okay. It's time to test your gear. Make sure you got a signal going through it. And here you can see why I chose the DSP version of this unit. It has a built-in compressor and equalizer. The The Zoom also has built-in EQ and high pass, but here you can adjust it according to the equipment that I use, which I'll show you in just a second here. So you can grab the specifications right from the owner manuals. I can use the EQ to tame that vocal presence peak in the 835. I used it to determine the high pass filter point so that I could just the right amount of bass material. And I also liked the settings that the Zoom uses for the vocal compressor, so I was able to just look into the manual here at the chart, grab the settings that Zoom provides for the vocal compressor, enter them in right into the DSP. Setting up a component level system like this is a little bit more involved than just plugging in a cell phone and a lav mic, but this does not represent the lengths that the studios go to set up their stuff. This is all a roadworthy setup, something that you can take with you in your car and set up in somebody's house or set up on location to do really good recording and get a good result.